We'll start. 51 are there. So in yesterday's class, we started with the next module, that is fourth module. So what is there in the fourth module? It is about multi-threaded programming. So in that, we'll be covering about what is multi-thread, what is thread class, what is runnable interface, creating threads, how do we create, in case if we create, can we create multiple threads? Then how the thread ends, what are the priorities, what is synchronization, using synchronization method, then synchronized statement, thread communication, using notify, wait, notify all, suspend, resume and stop threading. So again in that we have something called as a enumeration, auto boxing, annotations. So in this we have enumeration. Java enumerations are class types, the values and value of methods, constructors, methods, instance variable and enumeration. Auto boxing, annotation and metadata. Multi-threading fundamentals, multitasking, running two or more programs simultaneously at the same time. Multi-threading, dividing the programs into smaller chunks called threads and running them simultaneously. Thread is a lightweight process that executes some task. So this is what the life cycle of a thread, where we start with new thread and it moves on. When there is a work, it will move on to a runnable state. So when it is in runnable state, it moves on to a running state. Which process it wants, it takes and it moves on to the running state. When it is running state, it may ask some values from the keyboard. So then it has to wait or sleep or sometimes suspend. So these are the options when something interrupts. Then we say wait, sleep and suspend. Or finally, if everything is okay, then it will be terminated or it is end of the state. So in the same way here we say that you have entered some values from the keyboard. So then it has to notify, yes, now the work is given, sent back to them. Then we have something called as a notify all when the sleep time is resumes up. So you may say you wait for some time. So after that waiting time, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, then we have to go back again and ask what is happening. So that's how here we see about running, runnable and terminated. The life cycle of a thread, new thread begins its life cycle in a new state. It remains in this state until the program starts the thread. It is also referred to as a born thread, runnable. A thread in this state is considered to be executing its task or running. Waiting, a thread transmission to the waiting state while the thread waits for another thread to perform a task. A thread transition back to the runnable state only when another thread signals the waiting thread to continue executing. Terminated, a runnable thread enters the terminated state when it completes its task or otherwise terminates. So then threads are lightweight than a process. It takes less time, less resource to create a thread. Thread shares their parent process, data and code. Context switching between thread is usually less expensive than between the process. Thread intercommunication is relatively easy than process communication. Better resource utilization, simpler program design in some situation, more responsive programs. Thread class and runnable interface. Threading, multi-threading is built on a Thread class, and it's a companion interface in runnable. Both are packed in a Java.lang language. So all processes have at least one thread of execution, which is usually called the main thread. Thread can be created in two ways: implementing runnable interface, extending thread class. Implementing runnable interface, the runnable interface signature, public interface, runnable void run. Steps to create thread by implementing runnable. A class needs to only implement a single method called run. Thread can be created by any method with following steps, like main or construct with the following steps. Create object of class that implements run method. Create thread by passing object current class that implements run method. So we are creating, how do we create? So thread, or creating an object, we generally create objects using a new one. So then we are taking some variable where we store that object, that is t, then thread. So that's what here we can see, runnable object. So then we call our start method, which in turn calls run method and starts the thread. Okay, so in that case, how do we do? So class my thread, so runnable, which is an interface where we are using that. So whenever we are using interface, we have to use our implements. So and what is the class name? My thread. So in that, we are using a method called as a run method. So in that, we are repeating that I, printing how many times. It starts from 0, less than 40, it keeps repeating. Then public static void main, string arguments. First, construct a my thread object. My thread ta equals to new my thread. Next, construct a thread from that object, that is thread t equals to new thread. Then extending thread class, class test extends thread, so public void run. Then for int I equals to 0, it starts from the loop where I starts from 0. If I is less than 40, it keeps repeating the displaying of I and end of run. So then test t equals to new test. Then when we create object and we say thread to be started. So how do we use? We use a built-in function called as a start. So when we use a start, automatically it will start the thread. Even though we don't create any thread, Java treats the main method as the first thread called main thread. It is the thread from which other child threads will be swapped. It must be the last thread to finish execution because it performs various shutdown actions. Controlling the main thread, it can be controlled through a thread object. To do so, you must obtain a reference to I by calling the method current thread, which is a public static member of a thread. So general form, static thread, current thread. This method returns a reference to the thread in which it is called. Once you have a reference to the main thread, you can control it just like any other thread. Example, getting reference to the main thread, thread th equals to thread.currentThread, th.getName gives the thread name. The public class demo, public static void name. So any Java program should have this line. Then create a thread, display the values what you're getting through the object get name. So then set what we want to set that. So create object and set that particular name. So then using the try and catch, we feel there may be some error there. And we display that I as well as wait for some time. How much time we ask thread to wait or sleep. So 10 milliseconds we ask the thread to sleep. Then again it repeats. So repeats where it starts from n equals to 4 and n should be less than 0. It decrements here. The next method is a sleep method. The sleep method, static void sleep, long milliseconds. So that's what here in the sleep method, what we do, we use a long 10 milliseconds, throws interrupted exception, causes a threat from which it is called to suspend execution for the specified period of milliseconds. Choosing an approach, if you want to override many methods of thread class, then extend the thread class. If you want to override only run method, then better to implement runnable interface. Creating multiple threads, class my thread implements runnable, the string name of a thread, public my thread string thread name equals to thread name, then void public void run. So then try and catch. So for I equals to 5, I is greater than 0, then display I, then sleep. That is what catch system dot out dot println, then interrupt and exist. All child thread executes concurrently. Threads are started in order in which they are created. However, this may not always be the case. Java is free to schedule the execution of thread in its own way. Because of difference in timing or environment, output from the program may differ. So determining when a thread ends, as main is a parent for all the child process, we want main to finish last over all threads. How to ensure the main finishes last? Java provides two methods for this. One is isAlive and join. So isAlive, we check to determine whether the thread has finished its work or not. So join, waiting for a thread to finish the work, what is assigned. The syntax for the isAlive, finally Boolean isAlive. So what is this isAlive will give us a result, whether it is a true, whether it has completed the work or it is waiting. So that is what isAlive, that's the reason you can see data type is a Boolean. Returns true if the thread upon which it is called is still running, otherwise false. So syntax for join, final void join, here it is not returning anything, so it is join, and in case if you have any exception, it throws and interrupted exception. What is the join is doing? It is waiting for a other thread to complete its work. So this method waits until the thread on which it is called terminated. Pass my thread implement runnable string name. So here public, so what we are doing, my thread string thread name, name equals to thread name. So then run user method called as a run, run is an inbuilt method. What we are doing here, we are creating a try and catch, and we feel that there may be some error, so try catch exceptions are used. So in that, the for loop is used where start from I and till I is less than 0, repeat displaying the I, and wait for 1000 milliseconds, then again repeat. So like this, this for loop is repeated. This for loop is within a try and catch block. So then creating a main class. So for any of the Java programs, definitely this line is required. That is public static void main string, throws exception, then thread t1 equals to new thread. So my thread t1.start, system.out.println, my thread status t1.isAlive. So t1.join, main thread stops and waits for t1 thread to get terminated. Then system.out.println, that is main thread. So then thread priorities. So what is priorities? For which one you give priority? So now for you, the priority work is studying your second semester subjects, concentrating. Maybe after some time, you may get time for studying for first semester subject. So these are how the priorities are set. So here even in the threads also, we have a priorities, that is thread priorities. All Java threads have a priority in the range. So what is the priorities they give? 1 to 10 is the range given for a thread priorities. JVM selects to run the highest priority thread. Three constants defined in thread class, that is thread.max priority, thread.minimum priority, thread.normal priority, default priority 5. In case two threads have the same priority, as first come first serve order is followed. So in case two threads come at the same time, so then which one should be executed first? So in that also we just check which has come first. So that's what here first come first serve order is followed. So then JVM uses a pre-emptive. So what is pre-emptive? In case there is a priority thread has arrived and the low priority thread is executing, then what will be done? The low priority thread will be moved out, highest priority thread will be executed first. That is what is called as a pre-emptive. Then priority based scheduling algorithm. So which one is there, that algorithm will be going on. A thread with a higher priority than a thread currently running enters the runner state. The lower priority thread is pre-emitted and the higher priority thread is scheduled to run. Then what is context switching? So context switching is the operating system switch from running thread to a next. So the rules to determine a context switch, a thread can voluntarily relinquish control. So this is done by explicitly yielding, sleeping or blocking on pending input output. In this scenario, all other threads are examined and the highest priority thread that is ready to run is given by the CPU. A thread can be pre-emitted by a high priority thread. As soon as high priority thread wants to run, it pre-emits the lower priority thread. This is called as a pre-emitted multitasking, that is context switching. So here in this program, so what we are doing, priority of a thread. So start with the extents. So thread is a base class. Test multiple priority is a derived class. So in that we are using a method called as a run method. So in that display the running thread name and the current thread name. Along with that, so priorities also. What are the priorities given for a current thread and which priority, what is the next priority of the next thread? So then this creating an object for priority, that is with the name of M1 and M2. So then set the priority, whether we want to set it as a minimum priority or a maximum priority. After that, start the thread. So start M1, start the first object, first thread created, and the second thread created. Next is using yield. So causing the current running thread to yield to any other threads with the same priority waiting to be scheduled. So that's what here you can see. So what we do here. So class A extends thread public void run. So then for int I equals to 5, I is less than or equal to 5, i++. If I equals to 2, yield system.out.println. So condition is checked and when I is equal to 2, yield method is evoked taking control to a thread. So that's what here system.out.println, then exit from A. So next we start with synchronization. So what is the just exact meaning of synchronization? So better we take your movies. So in your movie, so if it is a pirated, so if you are having a movie with a pirated one, in that case, the sync may be lost. That is a lip movement of the scene and the voice comes later. Then that doesn't look very good. So that's what the same. So if you have a sync between the lip movement and the song, so then that is what is called as a synchronization. There is a synchronization between both voice and a video. So the same way, even in the thread also, there should be proper synchronization because we are creating a multiple threads. So when we are creating multiple threads, all the threads should be in a synchronized proper. So now say, take an example here. So second semester MCA students, classes starts at 8:30. So not for each one student, not for USN 1 it is 8:30, USN 2 is not 8:50, not like that, right? So everyone, your classes will start by 8:30. So that is what is a synchronized. All 60 and one staff at 8:30 has to take class. So next hour, one each hour will be given for each staff and it will be keep executing. So similar concept is called as a synchronization. When more than one thread try to access a shared resource, we need to ensure that resource will be used by only one thread at a time. So that's what here. So now your second semester students, now Tuesday morning 8:30 you have a Java class. So and one more staff cannot start explaining the other topic. So then that is not right. So that's what here, even the synchronization, what it do when more than one thread try to access a shared resource. So now we are sharing you the link. The same way now your second semester, you have a separate link, online link for a Google Meet. So in the same way, fourth semester also we have something else. So then it should not be combined. So that's what here, when more than one thread try to access a shared resource, we need to ensure that resource will be used by only one thread at a time. Only one should be using a printer system, or one should be using only one time. All 60 students should be using only one link. It should not be mixed up with the fourth semester. It should not be mixed up with the sixth semester. The process by which this is achieved is called synchronization. So this process, what we do, one time, one at one particular time, only one resource should be given to one particular thread. So this concept is called as a synchronization. Let me repeat, when more than one thread try to access a shared resource, the resource can be shared between so many people. So then that shared resource, we need to ensure that resource will be used by only one thread at a time. So the process by which this is achieved is called synchronization. So that's what is called as a synchronization. So what is thread synchronization? There are two types of thread synchronization, that is mutual exclusion and intercommunication, inter-thread communication. So what is mutual exclusion? So you may have Java notes and your friend may be having a web notes. Then you people, you say, you give me Java notes, I'll give you web notes. So you mutually understand, you have a synchronization between both of you. So that concept is called as a mutually exclusion. In the mutually exclusive, again, we have something called as a synchronized method and a synchronized block. So what is synchronized method? So now, even in your mobiles also, we get so many spam mails. Because if you have a true caller, you will come to know that is a spam mail, and we don't pick up. So in the same way, synchronized block. Sometimes the advertisements will be coming. Then what option we have? We have an option even in a mobile saying that let me block this number. So the same way here, synchronized block, we see them. So cooperation or inter-thread communication. So in that inter-thread communication, now I am communicating to all 60 students. So and you people may ask us doubts also. So that is what is called as a inter-thread communication. That is wait, notify, and notify all. So this is what all called wait, notify, and notify all. So that is what thread synchronization. There are two types of thread synchronization: mutual exclusion and inter-thread communication. So what is mutual exclusion? Exclusive. So that is synchronized method and synchronized block. Cooperation or inter-thread communication. So wait, notify, and notify all. So these are the methods available in the mutual exclusion and inter-thread communication. So synchronized method, what is synchronized method? If you declare any method as synchronized, it is known as synchronized method. Synchronized method is used to lock an object for any shared resource. Synchronization in Java is the capability to control the access to multiple threads to any shared resource. That is synchronized void print. So then synchronized statement, so just we have seen, so what is the synchronized method, synchronized block, wait, notifying, notify all. So now what is synchronized method? If you declare any method as synchronized, it is known as a synchronized method. So what it is, any method whichever you feel, if you declare that method as synchronized, then we call that method as a synchronized method. So synchronized method is used to lock an object for any shared resources. What is the synchronized will be doing? It will lock one resource so that that resource, until unless this thread completes the work with using that resource, other thread cannot be using that resource. So that's a work of synchronized method. So what is synchronized method is used? Is used to lock an object for any shared resource. Synchronization in Java is the capability to control the access of multiple threads to any shared resource. So then synchronized void print. So now the print method is synchronized. That's what here the meaning of synchronized. Synchronization in Java is the capability to control the access of multiple threads to any shared resource. Next, we move on synchronized statement. Not only for methods, we can declare it as a synchronized, but also for statements also, we can declare it as a synchronized statement. Synchronized block can be used to perform synchronization on any specific resource of the method. So suppose if you have 50 lines of code in your method, but you want to synchronize only 5 lines, you can use synchronized block. So synchronized block is used to lock an object for any shared resource. Scope of a synchronized block is smaller than the method. So synchronized block is used to lock an object for any shared resource. So general form, so synchronized object reference. So the what is what is the general form, how do we give a synchronized, so then you can say synchronized for which object we are referring, that is object reference expression, then the code block. So that is what is called as a general form. So then example, class bank int balance equals to 0, then the bank dot balance equals to 100, public void withdrawal int amount, then system dot out dot println withdraw amount is plus amount, then synchronized this method, if balance minus amount less than 0, then system dot out dot println balance not enough, can't withdraw money, else balance equals to balance minus amount. So what is this synchronized is doing? Synchronize this, it will check whether the balance whether the sufficient balance is there or not. If we don't have sufficient balance, it will wait. So the synchronized method will not check, because for that particular account we are checking whether the minimum balance is there or not. If it is not there, so it is wait. So that's what here the class, first we are checking balance is 0. If then we have a constructor where bank dot balance equals to 100, then public void withdrawal, how much amount I want to withdraw, that is a withdraw int amount, then system dot out dot println withdraw amount is amount, then synchronize this. So in this synchronized method, if balance minus amount less than 0, system dot out dot println, so what we do, whether the balance is not enough or cannot withdraw money, hence we are checking whether the balance equals to balance minus amount. Thread communication using notify wait and notify all. Inter-thread communication or cooperation is all about allowing synchronized threads to communicate with each other. Cooperation, inter-thread communication is a mechanism in which a thread is paused running in its critical section and another thread is allowed to enter or block in the same critical section to be executed. So that is what is thread communication using notify, wait and notify all. So what is this thread communication using notify, wait and notify all? Inter-thread communication or cooperation is all about allowing synchronized threads to a communication with each other. Cooperation, inter-thread communication is a mechanism in which a thread is paused running in its critical section and another thread is allowed to enter or lock in the same critical section to be executed. That is what is called as a thread communication using notify, wait and notify all. Inter-thread communication or cooperation is all about allowing synchronized threads to communicate with each other. Cooperation, inter-thread communication is a mechanism in which a thread is paused running in its critical section and another thread is allowed to enter or lock in the same critical section to be executed. So allowing synchronized thread to communicate with each other, implemented by allowing methods of object class, that is wait, notify, notify all. So that is what is called as a allowing synchronized thread to communicate with each other. So implemented by allowing methods of object class, that is wait, notify, notify all. So what we have done, thread communication using notify, wait and notify all. Inter-thread communication or cooperation is all about allowing synchronized thread to communicate with each other. What is this intercommunication is doing? So inter-thread communication. Inter-thread communication or cooperation is all about allowing inter-thread communication. So now you people are communicating. So whether we have a class at 8:30, which class we have, so that you'll be checking. In case if we change anything, we intimate you. So that's what your communication with each other. So cooperation, inter-thread communication is a mechanism in which a thread is paused running in its critical section and another thread is allowed to enter or lock in the same critical section to be executed. So that is what is called as a thread communication using notify, wait, and notify all. Inter-thread communication or cooperation is all about allowing synchronized thread to communicate with each other. Corporation inter-thread communication is a mechanism in which a thread is paused running in its critical section and another thread is allowed to enter or lock in the same critical section to be executed. So allowing synchronized thread to communicate with each other implemented by following methods of object class. That is wait, notify, notify all. So that's how here we do allowing synchronized threads to communicate with each other implemented by following methods of object class. That is wait, notify, notify all. So then what is wait? It causes current thread to wait until enter another thread invokes. It must be called from synchronized context, that is from block or method. It means before waiting method is called. So that's what wait, it causes current thread to wait until either another thread invokes. It must be called from synchronized context, that is from block or method. It means before wait method is called. Then syntax, public final void wait throws interrupted exception, public final void wait long timeout throws interrupted exception. That's what is wait. It causes current thread to wait until either another thread invokes. It must be called from synchronized context, that is from block or method. It means before wait method is called. Then what is the syntax we use? So public final void wait throws interrupted exception. So the public final void wait, so long timeout throws interrupted exception. So notify wakes up a single thread that is waiting on this object's monitor. Syntax public final void notify all wakes up all the threads that are waiting on this object's monitor. Syntax public final void notify all. Suspending, resuming, and stopping the thread. A program used to suspend and resume and stop. So which are methods defined thread? Suspending, resuming, and stopping the thread. So here notify, wait, following synchronized thread to communicate with each other, implementing by the following methods of object class. That is wait, notify, and notify all. So what is wait is doing? It causes current thread to wait until either another thread invokes. It must be called from synchronized context, that is from block or a method. It means before wait method is called. Then syntax public void, public final void wait throws interrupted exception, public final void wait long timeout throws interrupted exception. So notify wakes up a single thread that is waiting on this object's monitor. Syntax public final void notify. So notify all. So what is this notify? Wakes up a single thread that is waiting on this object's monitor. Syntax public final void notify. So notify all wakes up all threads that are waiting on this object's monitor. Syntax public final void notify. So that is what notify is doing. Wakes up a single thread that is waiting on this object's monitor. A syntax public final void notify. Notify all wakes up all threads that are waiting on this object's monitor. Syntax public final void notify all. So suspending, resuming, and stopping thread. A program used suspend and resume and stop, which are methods defined by thread. They have the form shown below, that is final void suspend, final void resume, final void stop. So here in this case, so what is suspend? This method puts a thread in suspended state and can be resumed using a resume method. So suspend, this method puts the thread in a suspended state and can be resumed using a resume method. So resume, so this method resumes a thread which was suspended using a suspend method. So stop, this method stops threads completely Once a thread has been stopped, it cannot be restarted using resume. So this is about then, and let us see how one small program. So the program is synchronized method and a synchronized block. So you can see here class table is synchronized and the method name is print table. So then in that case, what we are printing, just n into I. So what is n? So n value what we have passed. So then I, it repeats in the for loop. It starts from 1 and it is less than 5. It keeps repeating. This is system.out.println. N star I, try thread.sleep 400, then catch system.out.println. Then class my thread extends thread table t, my thread table t, this dot t equals to t, public void run t dot print table 5. Then class my thread extends thread table t, my thread table 2. So this dot t equals to t, public void run, then t dot print table 100. Then class test synchronized 1, public static void main. So that is for any of the Java programs, main method is 1. Then creating an object for a class table with a new. So then table, only one object is created. So then thread t1 is an object for a my thread, and the object is passed, and creating one more thread t2 and object is passed. Then start both the threads, that is t1 and t2. So that's what here in this program we have the how the synchronized method and synchronized blocks are done. Let me stop here. Before we stop, let us revise what we have done. So today we have started with synchronization. So in the last classes we have seen about what is multi-thread, what is multi-thread. So what are the fundamentals? What is task? So running two or more programs simultaneously at the same time. So then life cycle of a thread. So new, running, runnable, running, and terminate. Then life cycle of a thread, new, runnable, waiting state. So new state, life cycle of a thread, new. Thread begins its life cycle in the new state. Then runnable, a thread in this state is considered to be executed, its task running. Waiting, a thread transition to the waiting state while a thread waits for another thread to perform a task. A thread transition back to the runnable state only when another thread signals the waiting thread to continue executing. Terminated, a runnable thread enters the terminated state when it completes its task or otherwise terminates. Thread are lightweight than process. It takes less time, is less resource to create a thread. Thread share their parent process data and code. Context switching between thread is usually expensive than a process. Central communication is relatively easy than process communication. A better resource utilization. Similar program design in the same situation, more expensive program. So then thread class and runnable interface. So thread, multi-threading is built on a thread class and its companion interface is runnable. So both package are in present in a java.language. All processes have at least one thread of execution, which is usually called a main thread. So the thread can be created in two ways. One is using the implement runnable interface or extending a thread class. Implementing runnable interface, the runnable interface signature, that is public interface runnable, so void run. So steps to create thread by implementing runnable. A class need to only implement a single method called run. Thread can be created by any method, you know, like main or construct, with the following steps. So then first one, create object of class that implements a running run method. The create thread by passing object current class that implements run method. So then thread t, creating a runnable object, and call a start method to start the thread, and as well as run the method. This is one small program which we have seen how we can use a runnable interface. So the same way here, this shows us how the two ways we have told, one is using the runnable interface or one using the thread class. So this program shows us how the thread class can be used for creating a test for creating class for threads. The it was enough to enough though we don't create any thread. Java treats the main method as the first thread called main method, main thread. It is a thread from which other child creates threads will be spammed. It must be the last thread to finish execution because it performs various shutdown action. Controlling the main method, it can be controlled through a thread object. To do so, we must obtain a reference to I by calling a method thread current, which is a public static method of a thread. General form static thread current thread. This method returns a reference to the thread in which it is called. Once you have a reference to the main thread, you can control just like any other thread. So this is an example of getting a reference of a main thread. So then this is a program where we are created how the current thread can be used to create a get name and a set name. Then we have one more method called as a sleep method. So using a sleep method, we can make any thread to wait for a milliseconds. Using an approach, so which approach we select? So then we can move on for a multi-threaded. Can we create multiple threads? Yes, we can create. All child threads executes concurrently. Means parallelly, any number of threads you have, it will be executed parallelly. Then we have a two methods, that is alive and a join. Is alive, we will check whether the program is completed or it is in a waiting state. Then join, it will be waiting to join till the other thread completes its work. So the syntax are in the program. So then we have seen about a thread priorities. So in the thread priorities, the thread maximum priority 10, minimum priority 1, and the normal priority. Then context switching, the rules to determine a context switching. The thread can voluntarily relink control, or thread can be pre-emitted by a high priority thread. So this is a program where we can see. Then using a yield, using a current running thread to yield an other thread with the same priority or waiting to be scheduled. This is how we have seen how the class thread is being used. Then we have started with synchronization. What is synchronization? One or more threads trying to access a shared resource will be used one thread at a time. One resource, one thread should use the shared resource at one particular time. So this process is called achieved by a synchronization. So then thread synchronization, there are two types of thread synchronization. One is mutual exclusion and another one is inter-thread communication. So in the mutual exclusion, we can use a synchronized method and a synchronized block. And cooperation or inter-thread communication, so we can use a wait, notify, and notify all. Then synchronization method, if you declare any method as synchronized, it is known as a synchronized method. Synchronized method is used to lock an object for any shared resource. Synchronization in Java is the capability to control the access of multiple threads to any shared resource. That is synchronized void print. Synchronized statement, synchronized block can be used to perform synchronization on any specific resource of the method. So suppose you have 50 lines of code in your method, but you want to synchronize only 5 lines, you can use synchronized block. So synchronized block is used to lock an object for any synchronized resource. Scope of synchronized block is smaller than the method. Synchronized block is used to lock an object for any shared resource. General form, synchronized object reference, that is expression. So this is a program what we have seen. So then thread communication using notify, wait, and notify all. So how do we use notify, wait, and a notify all? So these are the wait, notify, notify all. So what is wait? It causes current thread to wait until another thread invokes. So it must be called from a synchronized context. So that's what here, from a block or a method. Then notify wakes up a single thread that is waiting for on this object's monitor. So then notify all, so wakes up all threads that are waiting on this object monitor. Then suspending, resuming, and stopping. A program used to suspend and resume and stop which are methods defined by a thread. Notice suspend will be doing this method puts a thread in a suspend state and can be reused, resumed using the resume method. Resume, this method resumes a thread which was suspended using the suspend method. Stop, this method stops a thread completely once the thread has been stopped. So I'll stop here and we'll continue in the next class. Answer your attendance. Anaga, answer your attendance. Anaga.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Abhilash. Akhil.
Ma'am.
Akrut.
Yes, ma'am.
Anusha.
Yes, ma'am.
Arvind.
Present, ma'am.
Arifullah. Arifullah, Peneka,
present, ma'am.
Panu Prakash,
yes, ma'am.
Bhargav,
yes, ma'am.
Rahmatullah,
present, ma'am.
Chaitra,
present, ma'am.
Chandana,
present, ma'am.
Charan,
present, ma'am.
Darshan. Darshan.
Present, ma'am. Present, ma'am.
Diksha. Diksha. Dakshaini.
Present, ma'am.
Kishan. Kishan. Harshit.
Present, ma'am.
Emilata.
Present, ma'am.
Ma.
Yes, ma'am.
Jayant.
Present, ma'am.
Divya.
Yes, ma'am.
Kaushik.
Present, ma'am.
Lakshmi.
I'm Lavanya. Chat box, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Manish.
Present, ma'am.
Manoj. Manoj.
Yes, ma'am.
Mohit. Mohit. Naval.
Present, ma'am.
Navya. Navya. Nikhil.
Present, ma'am.
Panindra.
Present, ma'am.
Pavan. Pavan. Pooja.
Present, ma'am.
Purnima. Purnima.
Yes, ma'am.
Raman.
Yes, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Rashmi.
Present, ma'am.
Rupak.
Yes, ma'am.
Sai Kumar.
Present, ma'am.
Sameer.
Present, ma'am.
Santosh.
Present, ma'am.
Sadab.
Present, ma'am.
Sharan.
Ma'am is present, is having network issues.
Shashank.
Present, ma'am.
Sheetal.
Present, ma'am.
Shivani.
Present, ma'am.
Soumya. Soumya.
Present, ma'am.
Spurti.
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am. Vishnu.
Sagandini. Sugandini. Sushma.
Present, ma'am.
Sushmita.
Present, ma'am.
Sushmita, you.
Present, ma'am.
Geeta.
Present, ma'am.
Trupti.
Present, ma'am.
Varsha.
Present, ma'am.
Veena.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. training.
Ma'am, I'm present, Mohit.
Why you people will not answer when I call you?
Ma'am, I was answering, ma'am. There was network issue.
Ma'am, Deeksha is also present. She has some network issue.
Yeah, marked. Any doubts? Any doubts? Yes, whatever I have covered today, any doubts, you can please ask us. Until unless you open up your mouth, we don't know whether you have understood or not. Yes, fast. Yes, any doubt? Or shall we stop? Madam is waiting.